Hi, my name is Søren Nielsen, and welcome to the first video in a series where I'll be going over every single feature in Spine. This guide will teach you how you can set up your skeletons and animations in Spine, and how you can use the features that we have available. Sometimes I will quickly touch on a subject, but not go into detail. You don't need to worry about this, it just means that the subject will be covered in depth later on. If a video for the specific subject has not yet been uploaded, you can always go to our documentation here, and then go to our user guide, and I'll be following this user guide very closely for all these videos. Also, please note that I'm running Spine on a Mac, so if I mention a hotkey using the command key, it will be the control key on Windows and Linux. If you would like to evaluate Spine before purchasing, you can download the Spine trial, which will let you try out all the features except for being able to save or export your project. You can find the Spine trial by going here and click the Try Now button. And we have downloads for Windows, Mac, Linux 32-bit and Linux 64-bit. Should you already have purchased Spine, just follow the link in the license email you received once your purchase was complete. And if you're still not able to find your license email, please check your spam or junk email folder. And if you're then still not able to find it, please contact us at contact@esotericsoftware.com. The first time you start Spine, an internet connection is required so Spine can download the latest update. If you're buying a proxy server, details for that can be specified, and I'll go into depth about that later on. After that, an internet connection is only required to check for new updates and download them. If you're always connected to the internet, Spine will download and install the latest update automatically, but this behavior can be changed if you would like to stick to a specific version of Spine. You can even go back to an older version if you'd like to. You can see the changes for each update at our changelog, and you can find the changelog right here if you go to documentation, and then go and click changelog. You can see the entire archive if you click here, and you can see all the different releases. So, I've now switched to Spine, and the SpineBoy example project will be opened by default the first time you run it. But Spine comes with many other example projects which can be found in the Spine installation folder under the example subfolder. And let me just show you what kind of examples that we have available. So I'm just going to go up here, click the Spine logo, and then open project. And in here you can see the examples that we have available. So I'm just going to close this and let's get started on how to actually use Spine. By default, Spine has the editor area, which is this area here on the left. We can now see SpineBoy. And then we have the tree view over here on the right. And I can customize the tree view by dragging the edge here to resize it, or I can put it in a different position by just dragging the tab and then placing it where I want it. I'm going to put it back here on the right side since that's what I'm used to. To access the main menu, you click the Spine logo up here on the left, and I'll go through all these different items later on. Panning in the edit area is accomplished by moving the mouse and then holding the right mouse button. And if you're using an input device without a right button, you can specify a pan hotkey. Zooming in Spine is very important, and to zoom in and out, you just place the mouse on what you like to see larger, and then you scroll the mouse wheel up or down, like so. And you can see it will focus on the area that I have the cursor on. Because of this zooming behavior, it is often more convenient than panning to just zoom out and then zoom in again. Now, if I was working on something really large, I could just quickly zoom out and then place the cursor on where I want to zoom in, and then you can see that I actually navigate the editor view very quickly this way. This behavior can be changed though, to always zoom in or out towards the center of the editor, and you do this under settings, which you can find up here. The zoom level itself is indicated by a vertical slider that we have down here, and this can also be dragged to zoom in and out. Of course, this is not as convenient as actually just using the mouse wheel. Now below this, we have these two buttons here, and clicking the top one will zoom to 100%, which means that the images for Spine Boy here are now displayed at their actual size. Clicking the button below here will zoom the skeleton to fit inside the editor view. Almost all actions in Spine can be undone by pressing Command C, and redo is done by pressing Command Shift C or Command Y. If you're not using a QWERTY keyboard, the default hotkey may use a different key, for example Y instead of C for a QWERTY keyboard. All these hotkeys can be customized. The last thing to cover in this video is Setup and Animate mode. Setup mode, which I'm currently in, is used to create and configure skeletons. Now I can switch between the two modes by just clicking up here in the left corner, and now I'm in Animate mode. And I can go back to setup mode by clicking again. For now, I just suggest that you go into animate mode and then go down here in dope sheet, which is also visible by default, hit the play button and then the loop button, and you can see Spine Boy running in here. I'm gonna just zoom it so he actually fits inside the view. Now, I hope this video has been helpful, and I hope you will join me for the next video where we will start going a little more in depth with the different features in Spine. So, thank you very much for watching, and bye for now.